Okay, Shami, give him one. The hardest that he has learned, or you have learned, the hardest you can find.
For P sine X, the P over here would determine the maximum and minimum turning point, which is also which would change the amplitude of the graph. So if it's a sine graph, then the amplitude would increase, and for example, the normal turning point, for example, normal turning point would be 1. So if it's 2 sine X, then the turning point would be at 2. Okay? And then the turning point for minimum turning point should also be 2. So that changes when it's in a sine graph. Cosine graph would also be the same, in which the starting point would be at 2 because the amplitude increased, and the turning point down here, which is the minimum turning point, will also increase and come to 0.2. The turning point would be negative 2. As for tangent, is the amplitude increases. The thing that is a bit different here is that normally you would see the value increase, like from negative 1 to negative 2. But for tangent, the tricky part is that the normal tangent graph would look like this, but for P tangent X, that tangent graph would become shorter, you know, in a way it would shrink a bit, and the amplitude increases.
Yeah, it becomes steeper, but it's almost the same concept.
Steeper.
A bit steeper, yeah, sorry.
Deeper. It's not shrink,
Shrink it.
Steeper.
Okay, alright.
Yeah, it becomes steeper.
It becomes infinity.
And then it goes to infinity.
So, how is it looking more straight?
Okay, next.
Amplitude will have a high and low amplitude. But if you say higher amplitude in P tangent X, that means that is why I think it is tricky, because infinity is a little. It's the signal you must watch the movie. The one that the name is Ramanujan is the one he chooses. Please look at the study the book, The Man Who Knew Infinity. He will explain to you. Okay. What is infinity?